Hi friends, welcome back to Joe Educare.
In this video, we are going to solve the problem on three-phase induction motor. Let's get into the video. So in this question, they are given about alternator and induction motor. So two machines are given. So we'll just read the question once. An 8-pole 3-phase alternator runs at 750 rpm and supplies power to 6-pole 3-phase induction motor. So what I'm going to do is, since you are having two machines, so I'll just draw it. First one is alternator, that is 3-phase alternator, which is nothing but synchronous generator, which supplies power to induction motor. So I'll connect through shaft to one more machine, that is your induction motor, 3-phase induction motor. So now you can just see 8 pole is given, so number of pole is given as 8, number of pole is given as 6. I need to differentiate for which machine they have given the number of pole, that is very important. In the same way, speed also, they are given twice, one is for alternator, one more is for induction motor. So to solve this problem in the simplest way, draw the two machines and make two columns. So write down the given data under respective machines. Now for 3-phase alternator, they are given as 8 pole, so pole is 8, runs at 750 rpm, so speed is given under the alternator, that is 750 rpm, and it supplies power to 6 pole 3-phase induction motor. So induction motor pole is given as 6, which runs at 970 rpm, so speed is given under induction motor 970 rpm. So this is the way to write down the given data, don't get confused. So now they are telling to find out the slip of the induction motor. So under this we need to find only one parameter, that is slip. After writing the given data, it is very easy to find. Now slip formula, under induction motor we know that synchronous speed ns minus actual speed n divided by ns, this is a formula to find out the slip. So now speed is given, this is the speed of the rotor, but we don't know what is synchronous speed. I need to find out synchronous speed. So which is the formula used to find out synchronous speed other than slip? So we know that frequency is equal to pn divided by 120, this was the formula. So under induction motor we have two types of speed, one is synchronous speed and one more speed is actual speed. So now synchronous speed, which will relate the supply frequency, so the frequency formula, we are going to change the speed as synchronous speed under induction motor chapter. So now I'm going to find out synchronous speed, so I'll rearrange this formula, ns is equal to, I will get 120 into f divided by p. So this is the formula used to find synchronous speed. Now if I want to find out synchronous speed under induction motor, frequency is not given, but number of pole is given, frequency is not given. So now what I'm going to do is, you can just observe the problem. Here alternator, under this particular alternator, they have given some of the data, that is pole and speed. So simply they won't give any data. So they are giving you some int to find out some parameter. So since we don't know what is frequency, we don't have any other formulas to find frequency under induction motor. So we are going to use the frequency formula in alternator chapter, which is same p into n divided by 120. In this alternator chapter, that is synchronous generator, speed is of only one, that is actual speed. We don't have any synchronous speed, only synchronous speed comes under induction motor. So the formula will remain same, that is p into n divided by 120. So f is equal to p is 8 into speed is 750 divided by 120. After simplification, I will get frequency as 50 hertz. Now after finding the frequency under this alternator, since your alternator supplies induction motor, the supply frequency will remain same for both the machines. So I'll substitute the frequency in this formula. So ns is equal to 120 into frequency is 50 divided by number of pole, this formula which I have written under this chapter, that is induction motor. So number of pole will be 6 for this particular formula. So ns is equal to, after simplification you will get as 1000 rpm. Rpm is the unit for speed, revolution per minute. Now this I will substitute in this formula to find out slip. So 1000 minus actual speed is 970 divided by 1000. So after simplification I will get 0.03. So this is the method to find out slip.
Bible verse to meditate on.
Check out other videos in my channel regarding basic electrical and diploma mathematics 1. Please support this channel by subscribing to Joe Educare and click on the bell button to get the notification regarding new videos. Thank you. God bless you all.